guy that we're looking to eventually going after. Five right now, that's probably because he's Georgia, I think it's the 4A or 5A state championship down there this past season. So Jacoby's a big, long defensive back. It's kind of what we're looking for in the mold of a Destin Mack to kind of replace that position in about a year or two. Josh Greenwood, Josh played at South Point in Rock Hill there. And we do have Josh's brother on the team, Ernie. Josh played on the state championship team there. He plays offense, defense. As he comes in, I think we're going to probably start him off somewhere at center. Played a little bit of center in his time there, but we're a little bit lighter at the center spot, so I think that's where we're going to start him off at. And just happy to get Josh into our program there. Corey Ibrahim, Corey's well-traveled. Corey has actually graduated 2 years ago, got caught in the COVID year. But Corey is from Raleigh, North Carolina, but actually played in Georgia for his senior year when North Carolina shut down or moved their season to the spring season. Corey went over and played in Georgia, played for Stevens County in Georgia, did a really good job there. Didn't get recruited there, so he took another year, took a prep school year at Myrtle Beach Prep, which was, I believe, the first year this year. Corey's an outstanding student. He's an older guy, that's what I liked about him, so we're gonna replace a couple guys at the A-back position. He's a thicker A-back for us. He's got good ball skills, got good speed. We actually had him timed at East Carolina camp when we were there. So we've got a pretty good idea of where his speed is. So we think that he's gonna make a good A-back for us. Hakeem Monroe, He's been at the top of our wide receiver board since December. We knew we were going to sign two wide receivers. Christian was the one in the December class, and then Akeem was the, we actually had two in the December class. He will be the third one. Akeem will be the third one. He was at the top of the wide receiver board. Just couldn't get him here in time, all the way from Florida, but a little bit taller than the other two. Got really, really good ball skills, got good speed. Once again, trying to replace a couple of those guys that were graduating here over the next couple of years. Hayes Weld is an offensive lineman out of Wren High School in South Carolina. Dad went to school here in 1994, graduate. He's on a really good Wren team. He's going to play offensive line for us. We're looking to put a little bit of weight on him. He's about 240, 250 right now at 6'2". We're going to start him off at the offensive tackle position, and was also on that 4A state championship team. So a couple of upstate guys in there in that group as well. That's all I got on the list. Any questions?
Just in general, what were you looking for after the December signing period, and did you get it?
I'll tell you, yes and no. I think we filled what we had to fill as we were looking for secondary, number one, so we were able to sign at least one or two more secondary guys. We are probably still in the market for a couple of guys right now. We're looking right now in the graduate transfer portal, fifth year, because we do think that there's going to be another round of probably portal guys coming out here sometime in the springtime. But we've also just wanted to gather some. There's a lot of transfer portal fifth year and sixth year guys so that they may have 2 years of eligibility left, which is probably what we're looking forward to the most. So probably maybe a D lineman, an offensive lineman, and maybe one or two secondary kids in that, which is going to be our next signing period, I guess.
As far as besides the transfer portal, what about any high school kids that you're still waiting on?
We're not waiting on anymore. This is it for this group, but we're still going to probably evaluate as they come in there and see what's left out there in the country, because there's always a few guys that are left. One of the things that we talked about as a staff is last year we wished we had a little bit more at the end of recruiting than we did. We kind of filled up really quickly there. This year I took it a little bit slower, wanted to hold a few back, not only for some graduate guys, but for some unsigned transfer guys, or unsigned high school guys. But there's also guys that come out of the academy. Sometimes they come out of the academy prep school that we'd like to at least make a run at.
Well, besides the guys that we already know that have left after the season, anybody else left after the fall semester?
AJ Trailer would be the only other one at this point, I believe.
So are guys still in the process of deciding whether to come back, or
I hope
your
not.
Spring roster?
Our spring roster is just about set. We do start spring football a week from tomorrow. So I do believe at this point we're pretty much set. Once the semester starts, it kind of slows down a little bit for us.
Can you run down who's back at A-back and B-back?
Well, that's a great question. Okay. A-back, right now we got Nakim back. Nakim Njoku will be in his fifth year. Cooper Wallace will be in his fourth year, I believe. We've got Javante Graves-Billups is still there. He'll be the third one in that position. We've moved local First Baptist Savon Washington to that position. He will compete there in the spring at that spot. We've moved another guy that was playing safety for us, Hayden Johnson, to that position to make four guys there, to make two extra guys there at that spot. I believe that's five. We have Sam Llewellyn, who's going to go back and forth between the B-back and the A-back spot. Sammy will be in his fifth year there. As far as the fullbacks go, we've got Amike Nwanze. He didn't finish the season last year. I don't know that he's gonna do a few things out there in the spring. He won't be full contact for the spring. Alex Ramsey won't be full contact for the spring. Probably won't get a whole lot out of him in the spring, but he will be certainly there in the fall. As of right now, moving forward, he'll be there in the fall. Logan Billings will be there, and then Sam Llewellyn will be there. And then we've got a couple of the younger guys there with Colton Mason, young man from last year, true freshman for us. So we've got, between the two positions, I would say we have about 12 or 13 possibilities.
Okay. And you are looking to hire a couple of assistant coaches, right?
Getting closer on those. Uh-huh. And the big thing for us was getting the finality of the strength conditioning coach, which we're glad to have that one. So once we hired that one, I was going to start to work on, I'm going to make some position moves on staff that is going to change a little bit of the dynamics of what those positions positions will be, but we should be able to get it all covered without any issues going into spring season here next week.
So you but you need two?
Correct.
Okay.
Need two, and you know, right now I've done interviewing for at least one right now.
And you mentioned Maurice Bono, he's dating Mitchell G, your sister.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. I think you said daughter.
Sorry, sister. Yes, sister. Sorry. Yeah.
I don't think he will. Clay's still on the roster, correct?
Clay is not. Clay finishing up, and he will graduate.
Okay.
He's just about done with his degree. I think he's just finishing up the internship right now at home.
I guess while we have you, kind of, what are you looking for out of the spring?
Development of our backup quarterback right now. Offensively, we're going to replace the two, or actually three interior linemen. So center is going to be a critical spot for us. We've got a true freshman this year that we're going to start off there, but we've got to find the offensive line lineup, and we've got some versatility in there. There's guys that have played. Terry Straight has played them all. He's always going to be the guy that's going to be able to move between center and guard. I'd like to keep him at tackle. I'm going to probably keep him at tackle to start. We did have the two guards that played during the season when JB and Tool were not playing at the guard spots. So we've got two guys that are going to fill in there with Bryson Jones is going to be there, and then Zach Blanchard will be at the other guard there. Mike Bartolucci will be the true freshman going in at center, and then Blanchard can go and be the backup center. So it'll be like a little bit like an NFL roster in there. We've got seven offensive linemen playing at five different positions, and then we'll develop some of our younger guys in there. But the most depth that we have on the offensive line is tackle. McCarthy will be playing baseball, but we'll stop Cole Owens at the wide receiver spot. Tyler Cherry will be a wide receiver, so we've got some good returners there at the wide receiver spot. A-backs, we already kind of went through. Defensively, return all, but I believe Willie won't be there, obviously, and then Dalton Owens. So if we can find a guy to replace Dalton Owens, we should be in pretty good shape on the defensive side. For us, it'll be developing Dominic Poole for a little bit. We've got Anthony Bowen back there who's got to be developed. Our safeties, you're not going to get a whole lot of looks at Chris Beverly. Chris has been doing it for a long time back there. Andy Davis has played a lot of football back there. So we're going to look to develop some of our younger players in the secondary at that spot. Inside linebacker with transferring of our inside linebacker, Willie being gone in there, we're going to move Hassan Black in to play inside linebacker. And then I think Jamason Roberts is going to be the other inside linebacker, a true freshman for us.
What's going on with Raleigh Webb and Willie Eubanks right now?
Raleigh right now is training. Yeah, I believe he was in Florida the last I contacted him. He's got an agent right now. He's training. He's getting ready for his junior day. We're going to run the junior day either back here in conjunction with South Carolina or Coastal Carolina. One of those situations. We're trying to get that situated with the NFL. And but he's doing really, really well. He keeps in contact with me. He shoots me a text about every week or so with whatever he needs. And then Willie is on campus right now. He's rehabbing still, and he is he's training with us. I just saw him in the weight room the other day. Looks really good, moving around really well. So we're hoping to get him into a couple of junior days as well.
Joey had been working with Donnell the last few years. Do you expect a pretty seamless transition?
We do, and I think there has been already a seamless transition. And my number one concern is when we started the semester off was having some continuity in that weight room because we have a quick turnaround to spring football. So we had about 4.5 weeks. And really, Joe took over, did a really good job. I told him what I was looking for out of him. And I think we've got it. We've gotten stronger. We've gotten bigger. We were in the process of really kind of evaluating all of our maxes here at the end of next week, just going into spring football. So next week will give us a little bit better idea, but I like what I've seen so far is when we missed all of our training last spring, I think it set us back as we're as Nick said, when you're a systematic approach, I mean, you have to have everything in place, especially here at the Citadel. We were driven that way. And when we got off last year, I don't know that we had enough training time to play a full season that we did this year.
You mentioned backup quarterback. Who's competing?
Right now, Ahmad Green was technically our third quarterback. Varney Farnbulo was our fourth quarterback. But those two guys are going to kind of battle it out there now. The one guy that's a little bit of a guy still coming back and working back into the mix really was going to be the backup quarterback in the spring of last year before he injured was Grayson Underwood. Grayson's very functional, and Grayson has done a really good job getting himself back ready to go after an ACL injury. He's strong. There's going to be a role for him on this team. So right now, he would probably be penciled in as the backup guy, and then we're going to probably fight it out between those three guys. Jalen's got a lot of football in. What we need to do with Jalen is just work on the things that we feel he needs to get better at.
Is the kid from Goose Creek gone? His name is
Steve. Yeah, Derek is gone.
Okay.
Yeah, Derek graduated in December.
Okay. All right.
Good. All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.